We showed the people what this weekend is actually about.
The song of the meadow is sung for reward. The stag in the forest was free. But gathered together we'll meet the storm. Tomorrow belongs to me. The Myrtle Cottage
has been at the bottom of Back Street for 210 years. It has been called Myrtle Cottage since 1850. Torridge District Council, in line with some stupid New Labour directive, decided to give everybody house numbers. When National Westminster Bank found that once upon a time there was a John Downs, that was my father, living at Myrtle Cottage Back Street, and now there was a Jonathan Downs at 9 Back Street, obviously I must be in league with Al Qaeda, it's part of the war on terror, so they closed all my bank accounts. They closed my bank account because of the embarrassment of having to go and sign for what was left in there. The sort of thing usually happens when you're £5,000 overdrawn and you're managing cheques. I've had £9,500 in there. But we sailed through. This last year we have had family bereavements. We've had stuff that you wouldn't believe if I told you. But we've had the strength and support of our friends and colleagues. Hell, you're not just my friends and your colleagues, you're my family, because that's what the CFZ is. So far in 2008, we have published 15 books, 3 editions of Exotic Pets magazine, 2 editions of Animals and Men magazine, made 8 half-hour TV shows, and a full-length feature film. We've got another 12 books, another 4 TV shows, and another feature film planned before the end of the year. No wonder, as somebody said, Karina, Richard, Graham and I look tired. Old Bear looks even more tired, but he's been sitting down all weekend, so everybody doesn't look in his face and say, oh, you must be looking tired, boy. The CFZ is a very strange institution, because we do what we do, because this is sounding a bit like one of Roman's convoluted Irish things. We do what we do because this is what we do. We don't do it because we're paid. We don't do it because we want to be famous. We do what we do because we think it's important. We do what we do to try to save the things that we think are important for the next generation. We do what we do so boys like Greg, boys like Connor, will be able to learn about things that has motivated the people of the generation above him, most of the people here in this room, because that ain't what they teach you in school anymore. Is anybody here from the Department of Education? Because at school these days, you are taught how to pass exams. You are not taught anything about the joy of knowledge. You are not taught to expand on the sum total of human knowledge, because basically, that is what the CFZ is all about. Now, I've got a little story to tell you before I shut up and go home. There's a young lady in the room here who you all actually know, because she welcomed you all to the village on the film that we showed at the beginning of the weekend back on Friday. And the night we were recording it, she and her mum were down in my office. And she picked up a copy of my latest book, looked on the back of it, saw my biography, and I winced when she said, "Mummy, what's an anarchist?" And then, 3 days later, I was in the village pub, and Clarissa asked her mum exactly the same thing. So it's actually not an accident that I'm not looking as suave and sophisticated as I usually do, and I'm wearing one of my old anarchist punk rock t-shirts. Because like I told Elizabeth and like I told Clarissa, an anarchist is somebody who does not believe in does not believe in governmental control, does not believe in being told what to do by people who have no conception about the way you live your life. And an anarchist is somebody who believes that the world would be a much, much better place if everybody cooperated together on projects for the sheer joy of doing them. And what do you think this weekend is all about? We've had Simon, we've had Sharon, we've had the Tiny Tots, we've had people from the elders over 60s club. We have had people from the church. We have had people from the chapel. We have had people from the pagan community. We have had people from all over the world, all coming together to put together 3 days of something which I think is incredibly, incredibly special. So, you guys, whether or not you know it, you actually are part of anarchy in the UK. Yes, they do, Verona, they do. No, no more heckling from the cheap seats, please, Verona. You've had your cake.
It wasn't a heckle, it was a word of encouragement.
Oh, dear, 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 dear. But why don't you eat some cake? Because I think we'd actually like to see Ronan do the cake eating competition. My friends, all of you, thank you for coming. If I look, I think it was Derek said to me yesterday, you look like you haven't slept properly for weeks. And the answer is no, I haven't. I don't think I've worked under 15 hours in the last 3 weeks. One night I did 21 hour day. Putting this together is absolutely exhausting, but by God, it's worth it. I want to say thank you to everybody who has helped, everybody from all over the world who has helped. I want to say thank you to all the people who've come, who've contributed, both spiritually, both financially, and both practically, to this weekend. And now I'm going to throw it over. We need more people. We have got a heck of a lot we want to do in the next year. In the last 12 months, as you know, as well as all the publications, the films, and the books, we've sent expeditions to South America and to Russia. We have done, as you heard, we, the people on the expedition, have taken the most ridiculous, ridiculous risks in order to try and push back the sum total of human knowledge. Ridiculous risks like Richard nearly being killed 4 times in Russia, Richard nearly dying of heat stroke in Guyana, and various members of the team, whose names will not be mentioned because it's probably a criminal offence, having brought back what maybe human remains, maybe Neanderthal remains, through the customs of Moscow Airport. That ain't a good thing to do when they were on the war, on the verge of war. But we did it. We did it because we're trying to push back the sum total of human knowledge, because we believe that what we are doing is important. I've been very, very heartened this weekend. I've had at least 3 people come up to me and say they want to help. They want to help in a practical way. They want to come and get involved. So, my friends, you're all welcome. Anybody who wants to get involved, either in organising next year's Weird Weekend or in helping with our publishing schedule, helping organise expeditions, helping work at the zoo, helping work at the museum and everything else we do, please come. You're all welcome. You are all my friends. And all I can say, thank you, my dear. God bless you all.